Hi, in this video we will introduce so-called complex numbers. As we have seen, not every equation has a solution. However, in many applications, such as vibrations of springs or in electrical circuits, these kinds of equations often occur. In order to describe the motion of such a spring or the electrical current in such a circuit, it is rather annoying that these equations don't have any solutions. For instance, it is clear that the equation x squared plus 1 equals 0 has no solutions. This becomes clear if we look at the graph of x squared plus 1. There are no intersections with the horizontal axis. In mathematics, there is a trick to overcome this difficulty. We just define a solution. In fact, we introduce an imaginary number I with the property that I squared equals minus 1. Based on this new imaginary number I, we enlarge the set of real numbers and define so-called complex numbers. Z is equal to x plus I times y, with x and y real, is called a complex number. This number consists of two parts. X is called the real part of Z, and y is called the imaginary part of z. Here you see the notations. Now the equation z squared plus 1 equals 0 has two solutions. Z is plus or minus I. Surprisingly, we can compute with complex numbers just as with real numbers. We can add, we can subtract, we can multiply, and we can divide with complex numbers. And always the answer can be written in the form x plus I times y. Let us look how this works in some examples. If we add two complex numbers, we just add the real parts and the imaginary parts, and we end up with a new complex number. Subtraction is similar. We subtract both the real and the imaginary parts to obtain a new complex number. Multiplication is somewhat more difficult. The multiplication is defined by expanding the product as usual. So here we get minus 2 plus 3i plus 4i minus 6i squared. Now we use the convention that I squared equals minus 1 to find minus 2 plus 6 for the real part and 3 plus 4 for the imaginary part, which yields 4 plus 7i. If we want to divide two complex numbers, we expect to obtain another complex number with the property that if we multiply this by the denominator, we get a numerator. By expanding this product, this would lead to a system of two equations which can be solved. However, there is a more elegant way to do this. If we multiply both the numerator and the denominator by 1 plus 2i, and expand both the numerator and the denominator, we see that the denominator gets real, and after simplifying the numerator, we only have to divide by the real number 5, and we end up with the answer minus 2 plus 3i. Now we have that every quadratic equation has two solutions in terms of complex numbers. For instance, if it can be factored, it might have two different real solutions. Z is equal to 2 and z is equal to 3. And if it can be factored into a single square, we have only one solution. Or in fact, two equal real solutions. However, if it has no real solutions, we can complete a square. Then this square should be negative, and with the convention that minus 1 equals I squared, we find two complex solutions. Now you may think that this is just an abstract game invented by mathematicians. But it turns out that complex numbers are very useful in many parts of engineering. For example, if you want to model oscillating systems, like shock absorbers in a car or if you want to understand how electronic signals pass through a circuit, it turns out that the use of complex numbers makes calculations much easier in these situations. Are you curious how that works? You can learn all about it at university. Thanks for watching.